You will never enjoy sex with your spouse for as long as you're feeding on pornography, because your standard of sex is where? Too high for a normal human being. And for those that are not married, now when you want to get married, you get a very innocent posibori kutoka hapa po machoke. Very innocent, doesn't even know anything. Then you bring her to Nairobi here. Pretty girl. And then you expect an acrobat from the roof. Hey. And because your mind is packed with so many women, you will never appreciate making love with her. Because the image in your head is not the image on the bed. You have to imagine the other woman, huh, to be able to satisfy this one. You have to engage your mind with all the things you have seen for you to turn this one on. Because this one is a different one.
It is sad when married people have to differ. Marriage goes asunder because of pornography, because of masturbation. It is called mediocrity. You're so mediocre that you have to copy a style from some Chinese, Japanese, Muzungu. Yani, can't you figure out what makes both of you comfortable?
Can't you figure out what makes both of you happy? Ah, the image in your head is not what you are seeing on the bed. One of the things that kill relationships, marriages, is pornography. Porn. You watch all the styles and then you expect an innocent woman that didn't learn from anywhere to whom the brain is given, sense is expected. If you fancy some of those things, talk to your partner about it. Teach your partner. You guys should experiment together. Or better still, even if you wouldn't teach your partner, don't vent on your partner when he or she is not giving you what you're already used to. And then, some of you are married men or married women that are already used to all these ifedi, eje, ifengwal. If you know, being married to somebody without experience is going to frustrate your life, don't even venture into it. Because at the end of the day, you are doing a lot of things to this partner of yours who may be trying to please you, who may not even know what is going on, who may not have any idea of what is going on in your head. So to avoid reducing your partner's self-esteem, reducing your partner's self-worth, making your partner feel miserable, don't associate yourself with somebody that you are not sexually on the same level with. Somebody that doesn't match up. Maybe for men that like to go 10 rounds, 50 rounds. Yes. And for women that like to do it for hours. And then you end up, because so many things need to be discussed. All of this is, it is always good to bring them on the table. We are no longer operating on the holier than thou, blah blah blah. Mm-mm. Everybody has wised up. Whenever you're in a relationship, whenever you find yourself in anything, even if it's marriage, have a dialogue, have a communication, express yourself, say all these things. Don't build your relationship on pretense, so that it shouldn't be too late eventually when you go into it. Speak up. And men, people, curtail whatever it is you indulge in that may affect your relationship with your partner. If you know whatever it is that you're indulging in may likely affect what you have with the person you love, curtail it. It is a habit that can be curtailed. You didn't come into this world with